embolization, and this is something else too. If you're going to choose embolization, or it's going to be given to you, offered to you at least, I would think a lot of these risks are not involved in the simpler procedure.
So I would tell you that if we're sending you home in 2 to 4 hours, and you're resuming, you're back to work the next day, we do ask patients not to have any vigorous exercise for about a week. But the reality is the complications from this are minimal and very rare. On the list that you saw, probably the worst thing is that one of these coils that we showed you could migrate and leave the vein and go maybe up to the lungs. But that's exceedingly rare. It's actually never happened to anyone I've treated in 30 years now. I don't know if it's happened to you. But it is a potential problem. There can be a little bit of pain, a little bit of inflammation. But I can tell you that in the past 30 years of doing this, I can't think of anything that I haven't been able to treat with regular over-the-counter Motrin or Tylenol. And that manages just about everything.
30 years, I'll take that success rate any day. You were going to add something?
Yeah, and as Jim was saying, most of those complications are self-limiting. The inflammation is sometimes we're blocking a vein, so you expect a little bit of inflammation, a little bit of what we call post-embolization syndrome. But as Jim said, it's over-the-counter anti-inflammatories, Advil, Motrin, and that's why, you know, with the exception, as Jim said, of heavy lifting, within 2 to 3 days, you're back to normal activities.